Blackstone Publishing presents Choosing to be a Medium. Experience and share the healing wonder of spirit communication by Sharon Farber. This book is read by Ann Richardson. Dedicated to my mom and dad. Disclaimer. Not everybody has the ideal emotional strength and stability to be a medium. Good mental health, including a strong connection to reality, is vital. People with certain types of mental illness, including clinical depression or psychosis, are advised to consult a healthcare provider or spiritual mentor before pursuing mediumship development. Do not engage in mediumship when you're feeling physically, mentally, emotionally, or spiritually unhealthy. Do not practice mediumship while depressed, drained, seriously sleep-deprived, or emotionally unstable, nor while drunk or under the influence of mind-altering drugs. Expressing belief in a supportive and healing afterlife is not to be misconstrued as, in any way, advocating suicide. Suicide is not a solution to life's problems. If you or someone you know is considering suicide, please call the National Suicide Prevention Lifeline at 1-800-273-8255 in the United States. Outside of the United States, contact the International Association for Suicide Prevention, IASP, at www.iasp.info/resources/crisis_centers. Neither the publisher nor the author takes any responsibility for any possible consequences that may result from the reader's use of content contained in this publication, and recommends common sense when contemplating the practices described in this book. Introduction. I'm not a morning person. I stay up late, sleep in, and am not usually pleasant before 9 a.m. This book emerged near dawn as I tossed in my bed trying to sleep, while spirit people poured ideas into my head. It was awfully early, but they were particularly persistent. I finally gave in, got up, and started writing. If they were working so hard to get me to do this, then we would do it together. My spirit guides give new meaning to the phrase ghostwriters. I started writing notes, made a list of topics, and created an outline. I told no one. This was between me and spirit. Several days later, I was taking a mediumship class in New Jersey and exchanging readings with another student. She connected with my mother's mom and gave evidence to validate her identity. Then the student moved her hand in a writing motion and told me that Grandma was encouraging my writing. My mouth dropped open. I hadn't told anybody about writing a book. I started the manuscript, and within days, my deceased grandmother urged me on. It was interesting that Grandma knew what was happening in my life more than my husband and children did. I continued to receive spiritual support and guidance throughout this entire book adventure. I agreed to write this book because I have a different perspective than many other mediumship authors. Most of them connected spontaneously with spirit people and didn't have to learn how. I became fascinated with mediumship without seeing spirit people. This book shares how I learned to become a medium, and how you can too. I am a massage therapist, healer, and artist who has chosen, with guidance from spirit, to become a medium. I have a BA in sociology from the University of Massachusetts, where I graduated Phi Beta Kappa and cum laude. I spent 3 years in the social services field before I decided I could be of more help to people with massage and healing. I've thrived as a healer for more than 30 years, but found nothing as exciting and fulfilling as communicating with people in spirit. I am passionate about connecting with those who've passed, and I am thrilled with the knowledge that there is an afterlife. I'm a natural teacher, so sharing my journey and encouraging like-minded people is an obvious choice. Unlike mediums who have been in contact with spirit people since they were toddlers, I'm an authority on becoming a medium, whatever your age. Choosing to be a medium will enlighten those interested in mediumship and empower and transform those seeking to become a medium. It's not necessary to decide which type of listener you are. Listen and see where the journey takes you. You don't need previous experience or encounters with spirit people to develop your own mediumistic abilities. If the spirit world fascinates you, but you doubt you have the gift, I dedicate this book to you. If you've already begun your mediumistic journey, may this book ease your fears and bolster your confidence. This book starts with a clear explanation of what mediumship is and how it works. Then it addresses every facet of spirit communication to help you become a medium or improve your mediumship. It guides you through potential fears and obstacles and teaches you how to quiet your mind, raise your vibration, increase your intuition, set your intention, and connect with spirit people. There's a constant emphasis on self-care, healthy boundaries, and making this a safe and sacred journey. The 65 exercises include simple, easy-to-follow steps and appear throughout the book. I encourage you to take the time to complete each exercise. In my own journey, I've participated in these exercises as a student and teacher. I learned or adapted them from workshops, mentors, and books, and some I believe I've invented. Many have been used for decades or longer. You can do most of the beginning exercises by yourself, anytime or anywhere. For the advanced exercises, you'll need to work with other people. Ideally, practice with those who want to develop their own abilities. But if not,
we hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.